shark won't tell you where it got its breakfast, so you need to find out the old-fashioned way, science. That's where researcher Yamilla Samara comes in. Southern California is known for its beautiful beaches, and the people who swim and work in the ocean here share it with all types of wildlife, including the biggest predatory fish on the planet, white sharks. Also known as great white sharks, live off the coast of California. And juvenile white sharks will gather together in the warm, shallow waters near certain beaches, while seemingly avoiding other beaches. Understanding why these young sharks chose those beaches could not only help protect swimmers and surfers, but also help protect these amazing and vulnerable creatures. But how do you figure out why a shark does something? It's not like you can just ask it.
Excuse me, ma'am. What are you doing here? Care to comment, ma'am? Why are you at this beach, ma'am?
If you want to understand these young sharks, you need to figure out what they're eating. That's where Yamilla Samara comes in. She's a graduate student and researcher at the Cal State Long Beach Shark Lab.
I'm actually from Nicaragua, and we have like a really big lake there that connects to the ocean, and we used to have bull sharks there, but they got overfished because we didn't really have like a good like fisheries control, and I never actually got to see a shark when I was living in Nicaragua. So that was a story that haunted me for like a long time when I was a child, and I just really became really interested in sharks in general.
Yamilla turned her love of sharks into her career and is now studying juvenile white sharks off the coast of Santa Barbara. Today, she's taking muscle samples, which she will analyze for hidden clues about their diet. The first step to finding out what the white sharks in this area are eating is finding out what food is even here. That's where this device comes in, a remote underwater video survey, or RUV.
What this is gonna do is take continuous video of like the sea floor and whatever is around. This is a really good way to like see what potential prey species are hanging out in the same place where sharks are aggregating.
While the RUV gathers information on the prey animals here, Yamilla prepares for today's main event, getting information directly from the shark. Using a long pole with a specialized biopsy punch on the end, Yamilla is going to take small muscle samples from the sharks.
What the muscle sample is gonna tell us is give us an idea of like what the shark is eating. Basically just looking at the carbon and the nitrogen within the muscle of the shark.
The nitrogen levels indicate how high on the food chain the sharks are eating. A low nitrogen level means the shark might be eating plants or very small fish. If the nitrogen levels are high, the shark is eating bigger prey with higher protein and fat content.
The carbon is actually kind of like a GPS. It lets us know like where that shark is getting food from. It's really different, the carbon signature for like inshore areas and offshore areas. It's also the same when you look at sharks that are also moving between like fresh water and on salt water. It's a different like carbonic signature.
With all the equipment set and sharks spotted in the area, it's time for Yamilla to capture her samples.
It is tagged, we can see it on the right side. We're gonna take a biopsy.
Her team has been researching this area for a while and have tagged over 24 sharks. So today's samples will help them understand the juvenile white sharks they've already been monitoring.
I think I have a number.
Got it.
So here's our muscle sample. As you can see, really small. We don't need that much. And we're gonna put it in the cooler so we can actually preserve the sample. And then I'm gonna like save it in another freezer when we get back to the lab. That's it. All my friends back home, like they didn't think this was a real job. So just the fact that I can show people like not only from the US, but from Latin America that you can actually do what you wanna do, it's one of like my main goals for the future.